Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Thomas fields it for 17. Leonard's the guy that comes out here on the road. The coaching staff knows that he is in a hostile environment. I think they're hoping that that's going to play in their favor a little bit.
Well, I think they want to challenge him. Over the year, I think they've seen that he has an ability to make plays, but when he gets on the road, he has a tendency to maybe to cough the ball up and not play as well. And I think that they feel like they can really try to challenge him, get this crowd into the game, try to crowd the line, put as much pressure on him as they can, and they feel that they've got a shot to slow him down. We'll see.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 23. They come out in a five-wide set. Now he tries to buy some time, and they got him. That's a loss of 6 yards. Slings it, and he's tackled around the 43-yard line.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. They cannot let these receivers get behind them.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
There's a fumble. They fall on it. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. He airs it out. It's knocked away, incomplete. Blackman was the intended receiver on the play, so that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Ingram fields it at the 22. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Offense.
So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. So it's first down and an eternity. They'll work the left side. Gets to about the 27-yard line. It fly. Great catch, and he's out of bounds.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
First and 10. Ball on the 46. Now he shows his running ability. And they make the stop at the 12. First down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and 2.
Tacks on the extra point.
A 5-play, 62-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Church
has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off.
Leonard takes it at the 16, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
One team forced to punt, Herbie, and the other one comes right back and gets some points.
Boy, Brad, this is exactly how you draw it up. You come up with a big stop to start the game off. Your offense moves down, gets points on the board. You can't start much better than this.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Tackle made at the 30, and the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
The sophomore just... the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
Second down and 7. Ball on their own 30. Out of bounds at the 33. Scrambling, and they get the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
And that's 3 and out. Nothing going on that series.
Ruiz to punt.
He really got a hold of that one.
Ingram fields it at the 22. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Nice run up the middle.
That makes it second and 6.
Second and 6. Ball on the 37-yard line. He's on the run.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, and that's hard to stop.
They'll give it off here. And down he goes at the 42.
That'll bring up second and 12.
Second and 12 coming up here.
Ball on the 42-yard line. An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 7-0. welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 39. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
To get the first here on second down. Inside the 10.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run. That creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Here's the eighth play of the series. They come out in a goal line set. Rose intercept. No, he dropped it. Unbelievable. He had a pick in the end zone and it just slipped right through his hand.
Wow. He is really kicking himself after that one.
From the 4-yard line. Second down. And he's got the touchdown. Gives him another touchdown to go along with the one he scored earlier.
This guy has great vision out of the backfield. Even if a hole isn't there, he's patient enough to wait for one to open, and then he hits it.
He makes the PAT. Church has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end or a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 21. And he's taken down at the 20. Didn't appear to be in sync on that series. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's got an opening at the 30, to the 20. Touchdown, big play. He's been a force getting to pay dirt three times.
This offense has just been running over the defense with the ground game. If they can't shore up the rushing attack soon, then this game is going to get ugly.
And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Leonard takes it at the 16, and down he goes at the 27.
The Mustangs know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
From their own 31-yard line, it's second down. They come out on an empty backfield. He's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack. From their own 28-yard line, third down. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle at the 41-yard line.
Perfect timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. That's a big gain and more than enough for the first down. Carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. They'll bring him down right around the 42-yard line. Under pressure, dumps it incomplete. Wanted the screen.
The ball was underthrown. It was a good read. He just needs to find his rhythm back there and step and throw the football.
Ruiz awaits the snap. Booming kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
Well, the way they played in the first half, Kirk, as they go into the locker room at halftime, got to think the coaches will be happy, but they'll want to keep the pedal to the metal, I'm sure.
No doubt about that. In fact, I think a good opportunity for them would try to be able to score early in the second half and maybe all of a sudden kill the will of that opponent. All of a sudden, you get those backups a chance to go out there and get some guys playing time as well.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield. The offense calls a timeout. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 18. Play across the middle. Locked down at about the 37-yard line. Nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. The Mustangs lost a player to an earlier injury, and unfortunately, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to come back today. He's got it with room to run. The offense calls a timeout, and now they've only got one remaining.
Hey, that's good. That's good. Mike 19. Mike 19. Easy, easy, easy,
easy. And he's tackled around the 43-yard line.
quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And a quick throw. He's tackled around the 22-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. There's a strike complete. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 14-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Nice play to set up first and goal. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He's got it. Touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
The PAT. A nice 9-play, 79-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, they're dialing up some good blitzes, disguising them very well.
This aggressive defense has enjoyed multiple sacks tonight. This defense is still feeling the pressure of the passing game.
Yeah, pretty decent average. So if they can do more of that, it'll swing the pressure around.
And it hasn't just been the work of this defense that's been impressive. Every unit has come through to contribute to the blowout. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
I don't know what these guys have to do to get back on track, but they need to try something.
Complete. He stopped immediately. The Mustangs call a timeout. That's their second of the half from their own 30-yard line. Second down. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at the 32-yard line.
That makes it third and three.
With the catch and knocked out of bounds. And we finally come to the end of the first half, and this one's not even close. 28-0.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
I'd like to put this more delicately if I could, but if this were a horse, they would put it out of its misery. This game is ugly and completely non-competitive.
No, one of these teams is not like the other. I mean, one's really good and one's not, and I don't know how to sugarcoat it anymore. Maybe we could say that the second half will be better, but what you've seen so far, you're probably going to get a lot more because I don't see any advantages or anything to take advantage of. One team's just superior in talent, superior in coaching, superior really in every single facet of the ballgame.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, you guys just sit there in your easy chairs. Kirk and I have work to do here in this third quarter. Hopefully it's going to get better. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this offense has been consistent throughout this entire football game. The quarterback's doing a good job of leading this team. How about the offensive line, the job that they've done? Just a great team effort to allow this offense to have a spectacular performance.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. They make the stop around the 34-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
option, throws it deep. And this one's going to get intercepted.
Yeah, a mistake like this by a quarterback, even with a big lead, is not going to make the head coach happy. When he walks over to the sideline, he's going to feel the wrath of his head coach and offensive coordinator for throwing that ball into coverage.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
That'll make it second and long.
So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From their own 25-yard line, third down. He's punished. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
Yancey is back deep to return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Yancey takes it to 25, and he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out.
I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
Runs outside for a nice game. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He gets hit out of bounds around the 49-yard line. Zips it to the tight end. He's taken down at the 47-yard line.
This is smart, efficient. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down. Can get it. It bounces out of bounds. He goes out of bounds right around the 34. The 34-yard line. Second down. Church goes with a play fake. He's tackled in the open field. Inside the 10. Touchdown! Huge play. The defense hasn't been able to keep this guy from the end zone. He's got 4 scores.
We wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
And he converts the extra point. A
A 7-play, 67-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Mustangs have just gone ice cold on offense. They can't seem to get anything going.
Right now, they just have to forget the score, forget the clock, just go out there and try to get a first down, try to hope to build a little bit more confidence and continuity on this offense.
They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Just throws this one away.
Man, it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
And he just gets rid of it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. A complete to the halfback over the middle. 2-yard pickup.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Setting up the play action. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Take 4, take 4.
Quick pass. The screen is good for 4.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Caught with room to work. And they push him out right around the 26-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Not much of a contest here as we head into the final stanza. 35, nothing. This one has been a blowout since the beginning. Hopefully the fourth quarter will turn things around. He gets rid of this one. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Quick to an open man, he dropped it. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Well, that's a nice stop right there here early in the fourth quarter, but they've made those kind of plays all day, and that's why we've got a blowout on our hands. And this is what power football is all about, folks. Play fake and looking to run.
I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He's knocked out of bounds, right around the 22-yard line.
Let's see if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game, or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Carry left side, brought down at about 39-yard line. That's a that brings it's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Wants to go long and does. Caught to the 10. Touchdown.
Trying to prove by doing this. His team's played a great game today. Close it out with some dignity.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A four-play, 81-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
Church has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And they can forget about returning this one. The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard. The ball here and brought down in the backfield. Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 22. Tackle at the 34-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49. First down. From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Just under three to go in regulation. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled around the 50-yard line. Second and nine. Ball on the 50. And he is drilled at the 47. He flings it right. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. That makes it first and 10. from the 35-yard line. First down. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. And he's going to come up with a sack.
That'll make it second and long.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires out to his receiver. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line. Third down now. They need to get it to the 25. Just over a minute left. Well, the stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. And I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room. Well, that one should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. That's a great tackle at the 43-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Goes for a short gain, but it's enough to get the first down.
Smart run. Maybe it won't look great on the stat sheet, but getting the first is what matters.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Just a total lack of competition today. The Blue Jays, 42. The Mustangs, nothing.
The Mustangs, nothing.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.